listeners, dear friends, look up. What do you see? The light, the electric bulb. Immediately, our thoughts go to its inventor. Who was he? Yes, it was Thomas Alva Edison. What a unique contribution he made to the electric lighting system. Also, part of his speech include unique achievers. Unique achievers means the only one exceptional achievers. Unique means only one of its kind exceptional. So, जो सबसे अलग है about that. So he just asks students to look up what they see. So they have a light electric bulb there. So it was he was talking about the electric bulb. Immediately he told them that what you thought after seeing the electric bulb. So we must be thinking about the inventors. He tell students that when we thought about the inventor, we recall Thomas Alva Edison, the inventor of electric bulb. Thomas Alva Edison, 1847 to 1931, was an American inventor and businessman whose inventions includes the phonograph, the motion picture camera, and the electric light bulb. Electric light bulb was one of his most unique contribution that he made in the area of electrical lighting system. So he make a unique contribution when he was alive. So he was talking about the unique achievers here, that one of the unique achievers is Thomas Alva Edison, who invented the electric bulb. Next, when you hear the sound of an aeroplane going over your house, what do you think of? Yes, the Wright brothers proved that man could fly, of course, at great risk and cost, but they did it. Who does the telephone remind you of? Of course, the one and only Alexander Graham Bell. Then he told them that what do you think when an aeroplane crosses your house over your house? So what do you think of it and first of in your mind? So then we think of the Wright brothers. The Wright brothers are the inventor of aeroplane, Wright brothers, Orville, 1871 to 1948, and Wilbur, 1867 to 1912, Wright, two American brothers who invented and built the world's first successful aeroplane and attempted the first controlled human flight. So when we think about the aeroplane, we think about the Wright brothers who created it. Of course, it was difficult for them to create it. It includes great risk and cost, but they did it. They invented it. So it was one of the unique achievers. They were unique achievers, and it was a unique contribution of them in the world of transportation. So he was reminding of him, and again he also talked about the telephone. He asked them that what the telephone remind them of, what they think when they see telephone. So they think of the Alexander Graham Bell, who invented the telephone. Alexander Graham Bell, 1847 to 1922, a Scottish born scientist and inventor who invented the first practical telephone and changed the way the world communicates forever. So he made a unique contribution in the world of communication. He was also a unique achiever. When everybody considered sea travel a tough experience, one unique person thought otherwise. During his long voyage from United Kingdom to India, he thought of many questions. He wondered why the horizon were the sky and the sea might look blue. He began to research this. His research resulted in the phenomena of the scattering of light. He was our own Sir C.V. Raman, and he was awarded the Nobel Prize for his work. Next, he told them when everybody was considering sea travel very tough and difficult, at that time a unique person, a unique personality thought otherwise, and when he was traveling from United Kingdom to India, jab United Kingdom se India ja rahe the, he thought of many questions. When he see different things in his voyage, in his journey, he just thought of many questions and just look at around. And when he see the sky and sea meet at some point, he saw that it looks blue. So he just began researching on that why we see blue color when sky and sea meet. So when he was researching, we got some phenomena means something that exists and can be seen, felt, tested and so on, especially something unusual or interesting. So he found out the phenomena of the scattering of light, scattering ke bahut sare kuch नए नए उन्होंने बहुत सारे इन्वेंशंस उन्होंने रिसर्च वगैरह करके निकाली. एंड हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट नन अदर देन आवर वेरी ओन वेरी फेमस इंडियन साइंटिस्ट सर सी वी रमन. सर सी वी रमन 1888 टू 1970. सर चंद्रशेखर वेंकट रमन एन इंडियन फिजिसिस्ट हु वर्क इन द फील्ड ऑफ लाइट स्केटिंग अर्न्ड हिम द 1930 नोबेल प्राइज फॉर फिजिक्स एंड ही वॉज अ नोबेल प्राइज होल्डर. ही जस्ट गॉट नोबेल प्राइज फॉर हिज वर्क इन दिस field. He was one of the unique achievers who got something different in his own field. Another unique achiever was a great lady of science who discovered radium. She won not one but two Nobel Prizes, one for physics and another for chemistry. Who was she? Yes, she was Madame Curie. Madame Curie discovered radium while she was doing research on the effect of radiation on the human system. The same radiation which she discovered affected her and she sacrificed her life while trying to relieve humans from pain and suffering. Another unique achiever he talked about was a lady who discovered radium. She was the one who did not won only one Nobel Prize but two Nobel Prize, one for physics and chemistry. She was Madame Curie. Madame Curie was one who discovered radium. She was when she discovered radium when she was doing some research on human beings, radiations on human system. So she came to know about the radiation radium, and from the same radiation radiation of radium she discovered, she was sacrificed her life. She was trying to relieve human pain. To relieve means to make pain or worry less strong. So she was trying to make the pain and suffering of human being less. She was doing research on that. That time she sacrificed her life. That radium affected on her and she just died. So Madame Curie was also one of the unique achiever who marked her identity on the world, winning two Nobel Prizes, physics and chemistry. She was the one who discovered radium and a very unique achiever. Madame Curie, 1867 to 1934. Marie Curie was a Polish chemist who conducted pioneer research on radioactivity. So here Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam discussed about many unique achievers about Madame Curie, Dr. Sir C.V. Raman and many more. So he was trying to say that we should do something unique to make ourselves some unique achievers. Now we will read a unique you. So it was the continuing part of a unique achiever. Whenever I describe great scientific inventions from the history of science, you all reacted at once. Each person who was responsible for that invention was a unique personality. Dear friends, can you become a unique achiever in science? You can. So as he continued that whenever he was telling that about things, about the inventions and all, the students are reacting the name of the inventors. So he said that you all reacted the name of the inventors because they are some unique personalities. They did something. They did something great inventions in the history of science. That's why you. That's why the students reacted at once. And now he was telling all the students that could it is possible for them to achieve such a great success in science. So he was telling that yes, they can achieve that. How they can achieve that? There was something that he continued. I have so far met 18 million youth. I have found that every youth, just like you, wants to be unique. But the world around is doing its best day and night to make them just like everybody else. It means that he was met around 18 million youth till now, till that. And he thought that every youth who he had met has something unique in them. But the world around them is everybody in the world was doing something so extraordinary, that so best day and night, that everybody was now mixing, and they are not, they are just like everybody else. So they should have do something very unique to make themselves a unique achiever. The world is doing their best, means जो आसपास के उनके जो world है वो भी पूरे best लगा रही है. Everybody is doing their best, so they should do something unique, something that is different from everybody to be to become a unique personality in the history. Would you like that, or would you like to be unique in yourself? The challenge is that you have to fight the hardest battle any human being can ever imagine and never stop fighting until you arrive at your destined place, that is a unique you. We ask everybody that what they want. They want to be like everybody else or they want to be unique in their selves. So he said if you want to be unique, then there is a challenge that you have to fight daily with the so much hard work. They have to fight hardest battle any human being can ever imagine. कि उन्हें सबसे hardest battle जो है वो fight करनी पड़ेगी if they want to become the unique. And they should continuously fight. They should not stop, because if they stop, they will not become the unique. They will be like everybody else. So they should fight until the end, until they reach their destined place. Destined means meant to be. They should reach their goal. They should fight until that, and in this process at last they will become a unique you, means they will become unique and will be remembered by everyone else, like the unique achievers we talked about.